goodness. Oh my goodness. What a performance. This is called Propositions. Okay. Another song. Oh no, it wasn't Propositions. It is Hide and Seek. I was too far forward. Hide and Seek. Oops. My bad. First before I say it, because I might be wrong. Yep, I was absolutely right. Vivaldi. Francis Monkman played in Sky, but he also bought the track Vivaldi as Sky's own version of an earlier track by fellow progressive rock band Curved Air, in which Monkman was a member. So that's why I know it. Yes. Hide and seek. Now we're getting on to propositions. Jim. Oh, this is so good. Really original. Finished rather suddenly. Rob won. achingly beautiful. Drums sound really muted, like you've put a towel over them when you're playing it. Is how that ends. Right. This is called Situations. Situations. This is incredible, isn't it?
But actions are the proof of love, not thought. See what a fool I've been. See what a fool I've been. I haven't lived by
I love this. It's a very typical late 60s, early 70s stereo recording thing where everything is hard panned. It's a great sound. You hear it on things like the Velvet Underground and maybe some early Hawkwind as well. It's just sort of very... I don't think Hawkwind's actually that old, but maybe it is. Where do they start? So many questions. That could work then. Excellent. Right, we are going to finish off this next track. This is the last track proper of the album. Vivaldi with Cannons. Well, I have got to say, that is one of the most interesting, unique sounding records I've heard in a long, long time. Compared with a lot of the other prog bands of the era, although obviously they weren't all called prog at the time, that was a made-up word at a later stage, but of the contemporary experimental rock bands of the time. This is really pushing boundaries. It's doing completely unique new things, and it's amazing. Really is. So there we go. Zoom in on that if you can. This is it. This is the album. This is the CD version. Apparently, when this came out, the actual record itself was a picture disc, which was a newfangled thing at the time. So that would have probably been quite a cool selling point for this record as well. Not only was the music sort of pretty amazing, but it had a completely newfangled way of packaging up the music as well on a picture disc. Absolutely incredible. I'm absolutely blown away by this. I really, really am. Steve, thank you so much for sending that. That's just brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. I've obviously got a lot more Curved Air to listen to because that is just one album. I think they must have done, well, they're still going. So I presume they've got lots and lots. Loads. I don't know what to sort of think about this other than it being so absolutely unique, original, sounding in some ways a bit dated, but in other ways completely fresh. So some of it could have sounded like it was recorded and released last year. But something about the vocals kind of puts me a little bit, and some of the production, a little bit in mind of things like sort of Jefferson Airplane. So you have that sort of late 60s sort of hippie vibe thing going, psychedelia thing. It's kind of, but it's all sort of mixed together and done so well that it's just, oh, I don't know. I really don't know. Marvellous. Right. Well, I really, really, really hope you've enjoyed this. And I look forward to seeing you on the next video, whenever and whatever that is. Until then, have a great weekend. This is Jim over and out.